Before us today, Donovan and Mark Lindsay, along with Mama Cass and Sam Riddle. We've got our own special goodies lined up for you today. We'll be picking the finalists from Los Angeles in the American Bandstand Dance Contest. Our special guests of the day do the Tennessee Birdwalk, Misty Morgan and Jack Blanchard. And we open with Steel Wool.
Yeah. young lady
who not too long ago shocked a lot of people was Miss Tammy Terrell. She made a lot of hit records with a good friend of hers and a good friend of mine, Mr. Marvin Gaye. This is one that I guess they've released as a timely memorial. Tammy and Marvin.
You can't forget it from sunrise to sunset. It's all in the air, you hear it everywhere. No matter what you do, it's gonna get a hold on you.
Beautiful sound. California Soul is sung by the late Miss Tammy Terrell, Mr. Marvin Gaye. Our special guests of the day are on the way right after this word. The thing that at lunchtime today I couldn't put down. I read one thing called Strange Experiment, and then it goes on through Ghost Town, Our Ghost House, Yule Revisited, More Confessions. These are little bits of columns that a fellow named Jack Blanchard writes for a newspaper in Florida. I want to show you the kind of a mind that thought up the Tennessee Bird Walk. This is a thing called A Look at Waste. I won't read them all, but he says, calling in sick when you're really sick, asking Glenn Campbell to sing Wichita Lineman. These are things that are typical examples of waste. Wearing slacks under a miniskirt, spraying laughing gas on Ed McMahon, issuing a guy bell bottoms and then making him cut off his hair. Examples of waste, a woodpecker with a headache, a snake with athlete's foot, telling teenagers about the birds and the bees. The man has a phenomenal mind. His wife is equally as attractive and interesting. This is a one-of-a-kind album because it really isn't made yet. This is if it shines badly, you'll know why, because we made this one up just to give you an idea of what it looked like. Would you greet, please, two very talented people, Mr. Jack Blanchard and Miss Misty Morgan.
Take away the trees and the birds all have to sit upon the ground. And take away their wings and the birds all have to walk to get around. And take away the bird bats and dirty birds will soon be everywhere. And take away their feathers and the birds will walk around in underwear. And the birds will have to whisper when they sing. And take away their common sense and they'll be headed southward in the spring. really want.
Kind of awkward. I'm standing behind you, so I said, I really ought to stand in front of you so that you don't have to turn around. We can get a better look at you, I think, because everybody's seen me before. Did you have any difficulty convincing the recording company to release that record?
It's awful hard to say.
We tried to keep them from putting it out.
Yes. Really? Didn't you have any faith in it?
No, we didn't, because we only had about 4 or 5 minutes to cut the record, and
we took it in one take.
That's wild. How long have you been married to this man?
7 years.
He has a weird mind.
Yes, he does.
He writes strange things.
Yes, he does.
Are all of his songs kooky things like that?
No. He has a lot of serious stuff he does, too.
Oh, I read that in a little book. That was an obvious question. Yes, of course. Were you always a singer, Jay?
No, I just started. I still don't think I'm a singer, but I started doing whatever I'm doing about 2 years ago.
What did you do prior to singing?
I was writing songs and producing some records up in Nashville.
Convince you to sing, as if I didn't know.
Misty,
did you have any difficulty with that?
Yes, I did, but then he finally did it, and about a month after that, some people came in the club, and they discovered us.
A legitimate discovery story?
Yeah, really.
What kind of a life do you lead now? Where do you live?
Well, what's the name of the hotel?
You mean you moved back and around, you've forgotten your home already?
Yeah. The Hollywood Plaza Hotel we're staying at right now, but, of course, our home is Orlando, Florida.
This morning was Utah. We were in Utah this morning.
That's a terrible way to live. Do you have a home?
Yes, we do. We have a home in Orlando, Florida.
Well, you think this change of your life professionally, running around, singing all the time, is going to change your way of life?
No, I don't think so, in a way. I think you carry it with you is the secret.
We wish you Godspeed.
Thank you.
All good luck. What was the inspiration for Humphrey?
I don't know. I think camels are kind of weird.
I agree with you. I never spent a great deal of time with camels, but this, for the benefit of those of you who haven't heard it, is the brand new release, the sequel to the Tennessee Bird Walk, called Humphrey the Camel.
Let me tell you about Humphrey the Camel, ambling across the sands. All the nomads giving him a great big hand. Mammal, and he's very, very hairy. All the sheiks know the swinging dromedary. Oh, yeah. Talking about Humphrey the Camel. In the middle of the night, by the light of an Arab moon. They say that you can see him stomping up and down the hill. He's a big, raunchy cat, but he swings right along. Of a Nashville song, oh yeah, oh yeah.
talking about hungry the camel. Down at the oasis, the Arabs are picking their dates. They're going to a party up at the Sultan's place. There's a camel named Amelia, and Humphrey's gonna bring her one big drink, and he's a seven-day swinger. Sultan's place. There's a camel named Camellia, and Humphrey's gonna bring her one big drink, and he's a seven-day swinger. Oh yeah,
oh yeah.
Talking about Humphrey the camel.
Oh.
I walk a mile for a
oh.
This is the distinctive sound of the Friends of Distinction. Friends of Distinction will top off this half hour with El Chicano. It's the second half of American Bandstand. In a moment or so, our judges will be selecting the finalists as far as Los Angeles is concerned in the dance contest. We start now with the Brotherhood of Man.
There's nowhere in the world that I would rather be than with you, my love. And there's nothing in the world that I would rather see than your smile, my love.
For united we stand, divided we fall. And if our backs should ever be against the wall, we'll be together, together, you and I. For united we stand, divided we fall. And if our backs should ever be against the wall, we'll be together, together, you and I.
And if the world around you falls apart, my love, then I'll still be here.
And if the going gets too hard along the way, just you call out.
Sit down. We'll find out who all's involved. May I have your name and age?
Nancy Mello, 16.
Thank you.
Bob Dangano, 18.
Thank you.
Debbie Downs.
Thank you.
Mark Schulman.
Thank you.
Vito Staden, 18.
Thank you.
Famous Six.
You're still wound up. All right. Is it next by any chance that we do that? Raider Record is next, and then we'll finally get to the dance contest I've been talking about all day. Actually, you know that we select a couple to represent Los Angeles today, and then we go on to ask our other friends to join us starting the next time around. Hold on, we'll be right back. Charlotte, my dear, have you got your pen all right?
Yeah.
I guess it's okay. We have Judy and Robert up here already. May I have your name and age?
Charlotte Regalado, 17.
Thank you. You know what your job is. We'll collaborate on that. May I have your name and age?
Judy Love, 15.
Thank you.
Robert Angiana, 18.
You look vaguely familiar. I think you were just over there a moment ago. So be it. Rate the record somewhere between 35 and 98, if you will, and give us your impression thereof. Charlotte, take one step back, and we'll check this one out by the glass house. I Can't Be You.
Bye.
group is called The Glass House. The song is called I Can't Be You. Judy, how did you rate that record?
Well, I gave it a 90 because I think that's what happened. And if you can't dance off of that, what can you?
Yeah, I'm with you. You know who wrote that song, by the way? Remember last week when the chairman of the board was here, the man who did the lead singing on those numbers, General Johnson, said, gee, I hear you're going to review one of my records next week. And I said, gee, your record? He said, no, I wrote it. And that's the one he wrote. How did you rate it, Bob?
I gave it an 85. I dig the singing and I like the harmony.
Okay, good enough. Our average is?
87.5.
87.5 for The Glass House. Let's see what they do with this one. It's called The Human Touch, the group that is. The song is Compromise. Touch, Compromise, rate the record.
Well, I gave it a 60 because I think it's behind its time.
Not up with today?
No.
Okay.
I gave it a 60. I didn't like the voice too well.
You mean the blending of the voices? You think that record has a chance of being a hit?
I don't think so. No.
You would agree?
Yes.
Of the two, you'd pick the first one. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Well, let's see what our average is. Oh, you've done a magnificent job. Speak to me, Charlotte. What's the average?
60.
That's the only thing you got to say all day. Human Touch got a 60, Glass House 87.5, and for each of you, we have Cool Ray Polaroid sunglasses, wired for action, tinted for excitement, round, thin, bold, and wide. Cool Ray Polaroid sunglasses with a remarkable Polaroid lens that locks out blinding reflected glare. And right behind that, complete Bell & Howell cartridge loading still camera outfit featuring the new precision-built Auto-Load 340 camera with a built-in electric eye for automatic exposure control. You'll get great pictures with this Bell & Howell with your very first roll of film. Think you can handle that?
Yes.
All right. Judy, thank you. Robert? Charlotte, I don't know when I've ever... Whatever. Thank you. We'll be right back. Mr. Entner, when do you go to Japan?
August. Yeah, the early part
of
August.
Not just you, the grassroots, the whole gang is gone. What is this? Is it in conjunction with the expo, the fair, or what?
Sort of, but it's going to be like a huge pop festival there of a lot of groups, you know, for 3 days. And supposedly, the way it's being set up is an amazing thing with the way they're going to have everything laid out and the great sound system and...
knowing the Japanese people, technically they'll have it down perfect. You'll get in and out with no hassle or anything. David, you writing any songs along with the rest of the things you're doing?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Do you write screenplays? I know you write screenplays, but do you write lyrics and what, the rest of it?
Yeah, I guess everybody dabbles in song and music, but and that's, I suppose, artists today, the thing that makes them different is the songs that they write for themselves. And
Is it hard to write something and then give it to somebody else?
Sometimes it's nice to have somebody else in mind or a style, because that gives you something, you know, for ideas for a song. So sometimes it's easier to write for somebody else than yourself.
Gentlemen, I've got to change the subject because time is a flitting away here. We have how many here, John? Five couples all together? I would prevail upon you to pick one. If you get stuck, you can pick two. Please try to pick one. These are all very good. You're not going to have an easy job of it. What will happen to them then is to go on to participate in the nationwide contest. We'll have seven or eight other couples from other parts of the country. But these will be our LIA representatives. So we leave it to you, gentlemen. Good luck. Once again, Creedence Clearwater. Job. We'll come back for your decision after this word about the prizes.
Well, the girl finalist captured the sounds of the 70s instantly with this Arvin battery or AC-operated portable cassette tape recorder. Records and plays back anywhere another of the many entertaining ideas from Arvin. Plus, matching leather accessories from Princess Gardner. Smartly fashioned, styled with today's girl in mind. Princess Gardner, a fine name in leather goods. For the boy finalist, a compact electric shoe polisher from Presto. Buffs and polishes in one easy operation. Accessories attach and detach with these, all new from Presto. Plus, an assortment of fashionable Farrah slacks meeting all of today's requirements. Smart tailoring the season's best colors and patterns. Farrah slacks and permanently pressed fabrics that never need ironing. For the three top winning couples, your own dance floor for your home from Flintcoat. The fantastic new Flintcoat peel and stick tile, easiest floor to put down ever. It's in decorator styles too. Peel and stick, just that easy, just that quick. In addition, for our third place couple, they each receive the Stellar Maxi Deluxe mini bike with chrome head and tail lights, chrome steel fenders, rear and front shock absorbers, big Tecumseh engine. Loads of fun, the Stellar Maxi Deluxe mini bike. Our second place couple each receive a color television console from the famous Spiegel Catalog Company. The Spiegel Catalog features over 50,000 quality items for the entire family. Spiegel, Chicago, Illinois, 60609. Our first place couple receives an all-expense-paid trip to fabulous Hawaii. You'll visit famous Diamond Head, Lie in the Sun at Waikiki Beach. You'll be staying at the elegant new Roadway Waikiki, offers the finest of accommodations, plus the famous tradition of old-fashioned hospitality that made the entire Roadway system so popular with travelers.
You think I could make an auctioneer in my spare time? Gentlemen, I know your choice was obviously difficult. Did you really reach it rapidly or what?
No, it was pretty rough. Everybody was really good.
I would hate to have to do it.
I think we ought to forget about the one big vacation to Hawaii and send all five of them to San
Francisco. Please. No, actually, they got a much bigger hill to climb than that. They become then one of, say, seven or eight more people.
Well,
and it's stuck.
Right here,
David, which couple? Gentlemen right here. Would you two folks step over here on the riser for a moment? Thank you. Just sit tight. We'll be back with you. Now, this is going to confuse an awful lot of people because you look very much like a fellow that was here last year.
That was my brother.
I know it was. Your twin brother?
Yes.
How much older is he than you?
3 minutes.
3 minutes. Did he teach you everything you know?
His
brother yelling out, he's your dad. May I have your names, please?
Oh, Stephen Rice, 18.
Thank you.
Linda Gibson, 18.
Would you be kind enough to dance out to time for whatever we have left? Let us see. Would you be more comfortable off this thing?
Maybe no difference.
Do it right here, then, if you will. Once again, Creedence. Ladies and gentlemen, would you join me in thanking our judges? They had a terribly difficult job. Mr. Rob Grill,
Mr. David Scholl, Mr. Warren Entner, thank you so very much. Let's check the album scene
for a minute. Hey, I don't know how those kids jump off there all the time. What do we got here? Number five we ought to start with. That's the Guess Who holding in the albums these days. Moving number four is the Jackson 5. Holding number three, four familiar faces with no title, fondly called the Hey Jude album. Simon and Garfunkel holding number two. The number one album, Mr. Crosby, Mr. Stills, Mr. Nash, Mr. Young, Mr. Taylor, and Mr. Reeves.
Lingering deep within your eyes.
Bandstand to Misty Morgan, two very, very nice and clever people. We thank them for being our special guests of the day. Great show next week on Get It Together. Martha and the Vandellas and the Moody Blues will be on right before we join you a week from today. For now, Dick Clark, so long.